Hey, what's up? This is Amarjeet from motionmango.com. Welcome again to another very exciting After Effects tutorial. Today we are gonna be creating this cool looking jelly text animation without using any third party plugins. So I request you to watch this jelly text animation After Effects tutorial till the end. So without any further ado, let's jump right into the After Effects and get started. Create a new composition. Name it render. I am going with HDTV 1080 preset. Let's make the duration 5 seconds and hit OK. And type your text. I am using a very beautiful font, Good People. I will put the download link in the description below. Click the align horizontal and align vertical to move the text to the center of the screen. Right click the text layer and make it a guide layer as we will use it just as a reference. Now, we need all the letters on its individual layers. There are multiple ways to do that, but I am going with a very basic technique. Like, I will type all the letters one by one and adjust the position manually. Now we will animate the letters one by one to make it a sort of revealing effect. For that, we will have to cut the letters into pieces so that our mask doesn't overlap the other portions of the letter. Like for the letter J, it will have 3 parts like this, and for the letter E there will be 2 parts, and so on for the other letters. Let's start with the letter J. Make it a solo layer. Draw a mask on the upper part to make it separate. Now duplicate the J layer. Delete the old mask and create a new mask for the second part. Again duplicate and delete the old mask. We are done with the letter J. Now, while keeping the revealing animation already in mind, divide the other letters into parts as we did with first letter. It may look tricky, but it's actually easy. So cut the letters into parts carefully. Take your time, but do it precisely. Next, to reveal the letters, or you can say parts of the letters one by one, let's draw a shape on each part. Solo the first part of the letter J. Make sure that no layer is selected and draw a shape on it. Let's animate the shape. It's super easy. Expand the shape layer. Go to add. Select the trim paths option. Expand trim paths and move 4 frames forward. Add a keyframe to the end property. Now come back to the beginning and change the value to 0. Now we have animated shape. Move this shape layer right above the target layer. Change the track mat of target layer to alpha. Now the process will be same for the other parts and letters. Solo the second part of J. Draw a shape on it. Adjust the stroke width if required. Copy the trim path effect from the previous shape layer. Select the trim path. Go to edit menu. Select copy. Now paste it on the new shape. And we are done. Move the shape layer right above the target layer and switch the track mat of target layer to alpha. Solo the third part and do the same process. Draw the shape. Paste the trim path effect on it. Move the shape layer right above the target layer and switch the layer track mat to alpha. Now select all the layers associated with J letter and press the U key on the keyboard to reveal the keyframes. Then offset the layer just next to each other, so the parts reveal one after another. Let's preview how it looks. Looks good. Again, select all these layers, right click and pre-compose. Name this comp J and hit OK. Now take your time and repeat the same process for all the other characters. It will take some time to do that, so I will speed it up to save some time. While pre-compose the associated layers for a particular letter, we will name the comp by the character's name. Once we are done, let's offset the layers one after another. Like when the first character animation will end, the second will start, and then the third one, and so on. Let's preview the animation now. Looks good. Now the fun part. We will create the jelly effect now. Before we proceed, can you please spare a few seconds for me? A lot of you right now watching this tutorial have not subscribed to my channel yet. I want you to please subscribe to my channel because I want to hit 5k subscribers to my channel this year. So make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon. Okay, let's solo the first layer J. Click the puppet pin tool and click on the letter J where you want jelly effect to be. Add multiple points, but don't be crazy. 4 to 5 points per letter are enough. You can see the puppet has automatically created the keyframes for all points. Go back 3-4 frames on the timeline and adjust the puppet slightly. General idea is to move the puppets from starting position to the final resting position in the direction of revealing. You can adjust it later as well. Once you are done with puppet point tweaks, let's preview this. It doesn't have the bouncy jelly effect yet. To make it bouncy, we will use an expression by Harry J. Frank. I will share this website link in the description below. Copy this expression. Now, Alt-click the position stopwatch under one of the puppet pin and paste the expression. Now Alt-click the stopwatch for other puppet pins one by one and paste the code. Once you are done, preview the animation. Cool. Let's select the next letter and add the puppet pins to it. Go back few frames and animate the puppet pins. In the end, Alt-click the stopwatch, paste the expression for all the puppets one by one. Let's repeat this process for all the letters. For the letter L, we will animate it and then duplicate it. After you are done with all the letters, let's preview the animation now. I like it. Let's add a background. Select all the letters and pre-compose it. Go to the layers menu, new, click solid, select the color whatever you like, hit OK. Move the solid layer behind the text layer. Let's add some glow. Create an adjustment layer on the top of all layers. Go to the effects and preset panel. Find the effect glow and apply it to the adjustment layer. Go to edit menu and duplicate the glow effect and increase the radius to around 360. Duplicate the glow effect one more time and this time make the radius 1000 and set the glow intensity to 0.2. Now preview the animation. Looks beautiful. Okay, let's go a step further. It will be a fun. But before we proceed, if you like the tutorial, please do like the video and subscribe to my channel. Let's get back to the fun part. Select the pen tool and draw the multiple line shapes along the design, or we can say along the text. All the shapes must be on the different layers so that we can offset it later. Once you are done with all the shapes, select the first shape or any shape, expand it, apply the trim path effect on it. To animate the end value at the third frame, add a keyframe with the value of 100, come to the very first frame and make it 0. Go to the third frame again. Now add a keyframe for the start value at 0. Move 3-4 frames forward and change it to 100. Now select the trim path effect. Go to edit and copy, then paste it to all the other shapes we just created. Now offset the shape layers along with the reveal animation. Let's preview the animation now. Looks great. Let's spice it up a bit more. Select all the layers except background and adjustment layer, pre-compose them and name it Final Comp. In the effects and preset panel, find and apply the shift channels effect to the Final Comp. Duplicate Final Comp 2 times. Select first Final Comp in the effects and control panel. Keep the take red from as it is, but change the green and blue to full off. For the second layer, keep the green and other two full off. For third, keep blue and other two full off. Now in the timeline, offset the top two final comp layers a bit and change the track matte to screen for both the layers. Preview the animation now. Boom. Stunning. Okay, if you have any queries regarding this tutorial, please let me know in the comments below. And if you want a tutorial on a particular topic, suggest me down there. I will try to make one. So that's wrap up today's tutorial. Hope you guys like this. You can follow me at Instagram as well, at motion.mango. We'll be right back soon with another useful tutorial for you guys. Till then, take care.